I had a very nice girlfriend of my daughter's, an actress called Flaminia Cinque. And she came and she was drunk, the drunk dog. And she was very good at doing that. It was like that, sloping up. She's wonderful, wonderful. And I did her as well, part of the Ostriches. I used her in the Ostriches as well. She's good, good model, wonderful. So then that, you know, I did quite a few of those dog women. That was that. Because, and then of course the Ostriches, you see, they asked me to do, the Hayward had a show which was called Spellbound. Spellbound was the influence of movies on art. And I was, you know, it was so such fun. It was Philip Dodd got it together. And I think he ran the British Film Institute at the time or something. And he, oh my God, I said to Lila, what are we gonna do? So I say, oh, something with Carmen Miranda, you know? Okay, because I'm a great fan. I mean, when I was at the Slade, in my last year, most of my time I spent in the cinema. I used to see three films a day. And I knew, at one time I'd seen every single film that was showing in London, every single film. I used to go all the time. And I've always loved film. I mean, my father had a little private cinema of his own when he was a young man in his grandmother's basement. And he used to show all sorts of films there, films he made films. Also, he showed, you know, Laurel and Hardy and Steamboat Willy, yes. Felix the Cat that I adored. And all that. So I was brought up on movies. And as a treat, you'd put up a screen and show me films. I loved films. When I was in Portugal, I was not allowed to go to the films, except with my grandmother, who had to take a picnic, da da. But when I grew to more teenager, we're not allowed except perhaps once in a matinee, once in a while. And I didn't see very many films. So when I came to London, the idea of coming to London was the idea that I could go to the films all the time and have as much ice cream as I wanted. So bliss. And as the plane, because in those days they had turbine, and the lights of London were undersprayed down there. And I thought, gosh, this is paradise, surely. And down there are all these movies I can see and all that ice cream. I used to buy a family block ice cream and have it all myself. They were disgusting ice creams, you know, nothing like Portuguese Santini. And they were like really Walter's ice cream in three colors and really horrible. Anyway, I used to love that. And I used to eat a whole lot. So I used to go to the films all the time. And I saw everything. Audrey Hepburn, I saw Shane. Everybody was talking about Shane. Shane was so wonderful. It was okay. But there was one film that a friend of mine, David Wright, took me to see in Hampstead, which was a true shock, and that was Buñuel's Los Olvidados. And it was about, it took place in Mexico, Buñuel was working in Mexico. And the surrealism in the film was limited to the mother's vision of the floating meat. And this bunch of real nasty boys who were like, you know, and they treated everybody really badly. They were little thugs. And they beat up a cripple. There was a cripple that used to travel on wheels, you know, had a kind of, not a wheelchair, but just he had a cart with wheels that he pushed himself along because he had no legs. And these boys beat him up. And I was so shocked. I didn't know that, I hadn't realized that people that were so hard up themselves, like the boys and their families were, could be so beastly. I had the idea that maybe people were so hard up and poor were nice and kind, you see. Some idea, some stupid idea, you see. And of course I was shocked and I thought, boy, this is something. And so I became a great fan of Buñuel's. I loved everything he did, everything. I liked Tristan less. It is not so. But of course, then there was Belle du Jour, which is, you know, life story, true life story. And then there were Nazarene, all those films. The discreet genre of the bourgeoisie, I did not like so much. I liked more the early films. I liked the black and white films. I became a fan of going, I liked, and then I went to see Pasolini as well. I liked Pasolini a lot. Theorem and that, and marvelous, and the Matthew according to St. Matthew, the Passion according to St. Matthew, which I liked. I have that on video at home. And I saw all the, I detested the Nouvelle Vague films. The person I detested most of all was Godard, Jean-Luc Godard. I loathed it. It was pretentious, it was just crap, I hated it. And that, I liked Louis Malle, and I Truffaut, and that, but by then film had become kind of different, you know?